Hello learners, in previous class we have studied many things about changes and today we will group these changes into two categories, reversible changes and non-reversible changes. So let us understand what are they. First of all, reversible changes. As the name suggests, such a change which can be reversed, they are called reversible changes. Now let us understand with the help of some example. First is melting of ice. When ice melt, it forms liquid, it forms water. Okay, if you again freezes the water, you will get back ice. So in this manner, this is example of reversible change. Next is blowing air into balloon. If you have blown air into a balloon, then you can even take it out. You can leave the balloon and the air will get out of it, and it will be as it was earlier. Third is folding paper. If you have folded a paper and on unfolding it, the shape will be again gained. So in this manner, these are the change which can be reversed. That's why they have been classified as reversible change. Now next, non-reversible changes. Such a change which cannot be reversed. If once done, they cannot be made as they were earlier. Let us understand with the help of some example. Cooking of food. If we have cooked the food, then we cannot make it as it was earlier. We cannot make it raw. That's why it's a non-reversible change. Boiling of egg. Again, if egg has been boiled, you cannot make as it was earlier. Conversion of milk to curd. So this change is also non-reversible change. Just because you cannot convert curd into milk. So students, these were the two categories. Now a flowchart will help you to understand it. The changes around us are of two types, reversible and irreversible. You can even say non-reversible. Both words are correct. Look, now we are understanding the example. If you have switched on the fan, you can even turn it off. So this is an example of reversible change. Tearing of cloth or paper. We can paste paper. We can stitch cloth. Softening of chocolate. You can put that chocolate back to refrigerator and the chocolate will become hard again. Breaking of glass tumbler. Now you may be confused. You may be thinking that you have been scolded on breaking some glass tumbler. So how this change is reversible? So students, one thing, you can heat that, you cannot, but yes, the glass is recyclable and we can recycle it. We can melt the glass and again we can give it shape. That's why it's a reversible change. Now the second is irreversible change. Let us see the example. First of all, conversion of milk to curd or paneer. So this is an irreversible change just because we cannot get back the milk. Second, ripening of food. Look, whenever the food will ripe or any fruit will ripe, any food will be cooked. So these are irreversible. And lastly, growth of plant and animal and even your growth. Once you have grown taller, you cannot become shorter. So that's why this change is an irreversible change. So we have seen many examples. Now this is a task for you. You are able to see many changes which has been listed in this table. You have to tell whether they can be reversed or they cannot be. So first is raw egg to boiled egg. Now think about it. Can we reverse this change? Of course, we cannot. Batter to idli. If you have cooked batter and now you have prepared idli, obviously cooking is irreversible change. So again, a no here. Then wet cloth to dry cloth. This is a reversible change. Just because you can again put water to those dry cloth and they will become wet. Woolen yarn to knitted sweater. This is also a reversible change. Just you have to just pull out a single thread and entire knitted sweater will turn into woolen yarn again. So yes, grain to its flour. If you have turned the grain into flour, then you cannot get back the grain. So no. Cold milk to hot milk. Yes, that's a reversible change. You can again make it cold. Straight string to coiled string. Of course, it's a reversible change. Now, bird to flour. Nope, that's not a reversible change. The flour cannot turn into bird again. Milk to paneer. We have discussed a lot. Again, no. Cow dung to biogas. Students, cow dung. Okay, when cow dung produce biogas, so we cannot reverse the change. Again, a no. Stretched rubber band to its normal size. Yes, you must have played with the rubber band. It's a reversible change. Lastly, ice cream to molten ice cream. That's again a reversible change. You cannot reverse it. Just because this molten ice cream can be kept in refrigeration and you will get back the frozen ice cream. So in this manner, we have done many changes and we have understood whether they can be reversed or not. Think about more changes around you and group them into reversible change and irreversible change. So that's all for today. Enjoy learning.